Good morning, student. Dear student, in a previous class, we had completed the properties of triangle, which is related to the chapter 15. Now, in this class, we will start the chapter 16, which is related to the congruence. I'll let you know what is the congruence, which are familiar in the class 6, similarities and congruence, line of symmetry, and angle of symmetry. That's a many types of the definitions were familiar in the previous class. Now in this class we will discuss what is the congruency, what is the congruence. Now congruent figure, you know, two coins, my two ends, these two ends are congruent because they are covered each other to completely. If this is my hand and if any small hand on there, suppose this is gold and my hand, what, that is congruent. If they are covered completely to each other, then two figures or two objects are congruent. The same numbers of the coins, that is coins of rupees 1 or coins of rupees 5, are same notes, that is 500 notes and 200 notes, they are congruent. So what is the congruent figures? If two figure have exactly congruent figures, if two figures have exactly same shape and size, same have exactly same shape and size, same shape and size, are called congruent figures. Are called congruent figures. Two objects are the congruent object when they have the exactly equal shape, same shape and same size. If they have the same shape and same size, they are congruent. Okay. Now, some types of the congruent figures. Two lines in it. First, two line segments are congruent if they have equal length, two angles are congruent. When they are equal measure. Third, two squares are congruent or congruent when the length of sides are equal. Okay, next angles are congruent. Two rectangles are congruent if they have the same length and width. If they have the same length and width. Okay. If two circles are congruent when they are congruent if they have equal radius. If they have equal radius. Next, congruence of triangle. Two triangles are congruent if pair of corresponding side and corresponding angles are equal. If pair of corresponding sides and corresponding angles okay. Now angles of two congruence triangle. If triangle ABC congruent triangle PQR, which is the corresponding side and which will be the corresponding angle? Here we see that the first letter is A and first is P. So A corresponding side to P and P corresponding side to, sorry, corresponding vertex, that is corresponding vertex, or you can say corresponding angle. Second is B. What is the second? That is Q. Then B corresponding to Q and Q corresponding to B. And third, C, that is R. So it is depend on the order of the name. First is A, first is P. So A corresponding to P. Second is B, second is Q. B, Q, C, R. Now, hence, angle A is equal to angle P, angle B is equal to angle Q, and angle C is equal to angle R. Okay? And corresponding sides. First two letter AB, then here the first two letter AB equal to PQ. Then last two letter BC, here is also QR. BC QR. AC and ER. AC equal to ER. Okay? Clear? And if you want to make the figure, I show you by the this A B C, and this is triangle P Q R, then angle A is equal to angle P, angle B is equal to angle Q, angle C is equal to angle R. AB equal to PQ. AC is equal to PR. And BC is equal to PQR. What is the symbol? So in which one cross line? That is 1 to 1, second, second, third, third. One line of angle, curve of angle, so 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, okay? You note it. Okay. Now, we will discuss the four conditions. Congruence of two triangles. Here you see that two triangles are congruent when their corresponding angles and corresponding sides are equal. They are congruent. Now we will discuss the four conditions in which if any one that triangle, two triangles are followed in any one, they are congruent. Okay. So first condition is given that SSS that is side condition. Okay, by side condition, two triangles are congruent when their sides, when there, if the three sides of the one triangle is equal or respectively equal to the three sides of the other triangle. Two triangles are congruent if three sides of one triangle, respectively equal to the three sides of the another triangle, equal to the three sides of another triangle. In triangle ABC and triangle PQR, if AB is equal to PQ, BC is equal to QR, and AC is equal to PR, A, B, C, P, Q, R, P, Q, R. Then AB is equal to PQ, BC is equal to QR, and AC is equal to PR. Then triangle ABC, congruent triangle PQR. Okay. If the three sides of one triangle respectively equal to the three sides of the another triangle, then the triangle will be congruent triangle. Okay. You note it. Okay, now we come on the second side angle side. Two triangles are congruent if the two sides and the included angle included angle of one arc respectively equal to the two sides and the included angle of the other A, B, C. That is two sides A, B, E, Q. A, B is equal to E, Q and B, C. B, C is equal to Q, R. And next, what is the included angle of these two sides? The angle which is formed by these two sides, that is included this angle and this angle. If this angle is equal to this, and angle ABC is equal to angle PQR, then triangle ABC. Congruent triangle PQR. That's clear. What is the meaning of included angle? The angle which is formed by the given two sides. That is called the included angle. Okay students, there are two more conditions are given there which we will discuss in your next class. There are so less time, we cannot complete the any one of the conditions. So we will discuss that in your next class. Okay, so it should be learned what is the meaning of included angle and the criteria, what is the condition of the congruence triangle. So these two conditions you should learn and you also will write that. Okay, thank you, good day.